Hi guys, welcome to Test Automation Framework Learning from Scratch. So basically we'll be looking at into the component integration and the workflow from this picture. So basically any automation framework is basically divided into two parts, the common components and the varying components. So basically what are the common components over here from this picture? We can see the Git or the GitHub, the version control system, the continuous integration tool Jenkins, build automation tool Maven, the unit testing framework TestNG or JUnit, and the reports API, reporting API, that is Excel reports, and the test data API, that is Apache Point. So these are the six components that are common across any framework. Irrespective of the framework that is devised for driving the backend APIs or a mobile automation, mobile tests, or driving the web tests. So irrespective of the tests that are being utilized for driving the various things, these are the various six components that are common across any framework. So coming to the varying components. The varying components are the APIs that have been chosen for driving the tests. For driving a mobile automation test, we choose an API, APM. For driving a web automation test, we choose an API, that is Selenium. And for driving the backend test, we choose an API, that is REST Assured. So basically this is how it was devised. And based on the test we are driving, the test scripts varies. If you are driving the web automation test, then the test scripts we need to devise it with respect to web automation using Selenium. And if you are driving the mobile automation test, we need to devise the test scripts using APM, utilizing APM. And if you are driving the backend APIs, then we need to utilize REST Assured to devise the test scripts. So these are the varying components. So an overview again, framework is divided into two parts, that is varying components and the common components. As you have seen, the common components are the GitHub, Jenkins, Maven, TestNG, Extend Reports, and then Apache Point API. So these are the six components that are common, and the device that are APIs that have been chosen, may it be Selenium, may it be APM, or may it be REST Assured, that varies, and the automation scripts. And the methods, wrapper methods that we are utilizing varies. So these are the varying components and these are the common components. So this is the common, this is with respect to component integration. And now let's come to discussion on workflow. So what happens basically, when we got a new feature, developers will be starting with the new feature developing, and then the QA is ready to start with analyzing the things, and then they start with writing their basic tests, the manual tests, and then they come up with once the things are ready from the development, and they come with the test written in the test scripts written in Selenium, or the test script written using APM, or test scripts written using REST Assured. So once any changes were pushed by the developers to the GitHub. So GitHub, once they are pushed to GitHub, Jenkins has a job that was pointing up with the webhook URL to the GitHub to check in if there are any merges, any code changes. If there are any code changes, trigger the build automatically. So what Jenkins' job will be doing? Jenkins' job has a Maven goal setup. So Maven goal, what is the Maven goals? What are the different types of Maven goals? What are the different types of phases which you have in Maven? May it be a package goal, may it be a package phase, or may it be the install, or may it be a compile phase. So various phases that were there as a part of the lifecycle of Maven. So based on that, whatever it was devised as a part of the job, Jenkins job, that will be triggered. That particular goal, that particular goal will be triggered as a part of Jenkins automatic job triggering. Once it was done, Maven will call the TestNG, using the test plugin, test execution plugin, that is a surefire plugin. It calls the TestNG.xml file, and whatever the tests that were configured as a part of the TestNG.xml file, which were included, all the tests will be executed one after the other based on the groupings or based on the priorities, etc. So when the tests are being executed, they pull up the test data using the Apache Poi API, using the utility methods available for driving the test data to the automation scripts. And the test automation scripts utilize the test data from the Excel suite, and they start executing the scripts over the mobile device or over the web automation, that is UI, or maybe it will be utilized and the test scripts will be executed on the APIs. So once execution is completed, the report is getting ready based on the pass or fail status of the test scripts. So here we are utilizing not the inbuilt plugin, inbuilt reporting feature of TestNG, but not the HTML report we are using, but we are extending it, customizing it using the Accident Report. Accident Report has a very beautiful customization features that gives a beautiful test report which can be distributed to our clients, or which can be distributed to higher level management, which is very useful, which is customized reporting. So this is the end-to-end workflow of any test automation framework. So our basic interest over here is UI automation, that is web automation using Selenium as a part of this series. So let's concentrate on them. So let's go into the topic that needs to be covered as a part of Selenium automation agenda. So first, basically, let's look at the prerequisite that needs to be understood. So we need to download an IDE which is utilized for automating, writing the test scripts over here. So that can be an Eclipse, that can be an NetBeans, etc. And then installing the plugins, TestNG, Maven, etc. And then one basic programming language, may it be a Java, may it be a C#, may it be Python, JavaScript, etc. with strong understanding of OOPs concept and collections. This is the priority. This is the preliminary prerequisite that is required for starting up with any automation framework. And then once we are ready with these things, we'll be delving deep into Selenium basic interaction, architecture overview, and then, as you have seen, the common components that need to be integrated, the integration of build automation tool that is a Maven, and we'll be looking at various things in Maven, like what is Maven, why it is used for, what is form.xml file, how we configure various things, like what are the various dependencies that we can configure, how to configure the dependencies, how to configure the plugins, how to utilize them, and what are the various life cycles that are available as a part of Maven. And finally, we'll see how to create a simple Maven project. And followed by that, next component of integration we'll be looking at. The next component of integration is the unit testing framework integration, that is the TestNG. So what will we be looking as a part of it? What is TestNG and why we are going to use TestNG? And what are the basic reporting that is available as a part of TestNG? And how to use various things like the data like the data provider, etc. for driving the tests. And then the various annotations as then the data provider annotation. So, and where we are going to use this TestNG annotation in our automation framework, that is for driving the tests. Using the test data, we are going to basically utilize this framework for. And once this component of integration is completed, and then we'll fall back to the next component of integration, that is the version control system. Here we are going to basically concentrate on Git and GitHub. So we'll start with Git Eclipse integration, and then installation of Git and GitHub account creation, and then we start with working with Git and GitHub. Once this component has been completed, then we'll fall back to the integration of continuous integration tool, Jenkins, installation of Jenkins, managing the plugins, and then configuring the various components to Jenkins, and then devising job, and then scheduling the job for automatic build trigger purpose. So these are the various components as we have already spoken of for integrating. And once this has been completed, we'll come up with the object identification strategies for Selenium. So what are the basic identification strategies? Selenium supports CSS, XPath, and JavaScript executor. So these are the basic things we'll be going it into. And before that, we'll see the basic concepts like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And followed by that, we'll come to an understanding of these object identification strategies. And once this was then completed, and then we'll fall back to the overview of base object model. This is the design pattern we'll be discussing with. in our framework, and this is how this is the design pattern we'll be utilizing for devising our framework. And then we'll start with the framework design and set up using the PS object model. So basically, we'll choose some application, maybe Gmail or maybe a Facebook, and we'll start writing some basic tests. Well, not the basic tests, but we'll be looking at how to utilize everything, all the components, how to put assertions, how to use the location strategies for dynamically varying UI, etc. So let's see one after other. So this is these are the various topics we are going to cover as part of this framework, and also we'll be covering up how to prepare the wrapper methods using Selenium wrapper methods utilities, wrapper methods and utilities, and how to devise that reporting, and how to utilize listeners, etc. as a part of framework discussion. And that we'll be looking at the end of this discussion. Then we are going to start preparing the framework design. Then we'll be looking at all these components integration, and then how to integrate these all things. So this is all. In the next videos, we'll be starting with the basic Selenium discussion and architecture overview, and followed by the various components integration one after the other. So this is our agenda for Selenium automation. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.